Scripts can be added to FDMEE, providing a huge amount of flexibility for extending and improving upon FDMEE's default behavior. Various languages are available for use in different areas of FDMEE. However, Jython is the primary scripting language used, as it's the only language that can be used across all areas of the system. Jython is an implementation of the Python scripting language, which is written in and integrated with Java. This makes it particularly well suited for interacting with FDMEE's details, as it's a Java-based application. Jython is also platform independent and doesn't rely on Microsoft technology in order to run. This is perhaps important to consider when thinking about the future, as it would appear that Oracle's strategy involves moving to a platform independent model. Beyond recognizing the language to use for developing scripts, it's also important to note that FDMEE distinguishes between different types of script. The available script types are import scripts, mapping scripts, event scripts, and custom scripts. Each of these script types exhibit their own behaviors, enabling you to customize your application in different ways. Import scripts allow you to customize details as they're brought into FDMEE. These allow your import formats to be much more flexible, as they allow you to test and manipulate source details using custom logic. After developing import scripts and ensuring that they're stored in the correct location, these scripts can then be attached to a single field in an import format. This means that an import format may make use of multiple scripts in order to perform the customizations that are required. Regarding attaching scripts to the fields of an import format, this can be done using a script expression. This is added to an import format in the same way as any of the other expression types that you may be more familiar with. A filtered list of available scripts is given in the expression value drop-down when performing this operation, making it very straightforward to make use of the scripts after creating them and adding them to FDMEE. Mapping scripts allow you to add conditional logic to your application. These can improve upon the default mapping process by allowing you to perform more complex operations. It's actually possible to write mapping scripts using either Jython or using SQL. Both of these allow us to perform the same sorts of operations, and so we will be concentrating on the use of Jython for these scripts in the course. The main difference between using a script for a mapping, as opposed to using, say, a multi-dimensional mapping, is that in scripts, we're able to update the target value for the selected dimension, but we're also able to update the target values for other dimensions as well. This provides us with a lot of power and a lot of control for our mapping process, though we also need to be careful to make sure that these scripts will run efficiently and won't slow the process down too much. Mapping scripts are treated in a slightly different way to the other script types that we're discussing here in terms of where they're stored, but we will be exploring that in detail in the mapping script section of the course. Event scripts allow you to customize the default behavior of FDMEE at the various stages of its standard import, validate, and export process. This allows you to achieve quite broad effects with your scripts, customizing the process in all kinds of different ways. This could be used to generate new files, move details between databases, perform custom validations, or perform any number of other activities. That process is actually broader than it may appear from the data load workbench and is actually broken down into multiple steps, as indicated on the right-hand side of this slide. Before or after the execution of any of these steps, we can add scripts to add our own custom logic to the standard process. Event scripts provide you with a lot of flexibility here, as mentioned, and we will be going over some of the most common uses of event scripts in more detail in the relevant section of the course. And finally, custom scripts differ somewhat from the import, mapping, and event scripts that we've seen so far, in that these are typically run on an ad hoc basis as needed, and they don't typically alter the standard process in FDMEE. Import scripts impact the way that import formats function on the import step. Mapping scripts dictate the way that mappings are run at the validate step. And as discussed previously, event scripts can be used to customize any part of that standard process. Custom scripts instead are held in a library of registered scripts, and these can be selected from on an ad hoc basis, and these allow you to perform bulk or batch type activities. Custom scripts can be provided with parameters, allowing users of the system to have some say in the execution of those scripts. And these provide a really useful method for backing up application elements or creating custom reports and things like that. Although the way that we register and the way that we run these custom scripts is different though, you'll see that when we get to that section of the course, the actual logic and the syntax that used is very similar to the other script types. Throughout the course, we will be spending significant time looking at each of these script types and seeing how we might use them to get the most out of our FDMEE application.